Well, hello there, people. You may see something over here or over there that you'd probably think, why is Windows here when he's going to talk about the most popular system, operating system for open source? Well, it's because it is Windows. It's not Linux. It's not FreeBSD. And you will, right now, if you're an open source or FreeBSD fan, let me put it that way, you will be throwing shit at your screen, and if you could strangle me, you know, take your hands through the fucking screen, you'll strangle me. But there is a little bit of meaning behind my madness here. Listen to what I said. What is the most popular operating system for open source? What is the most popular operating system from open source? Not what is the most popular open source operating system. So what do I mean by what is the most popular operating system for open source? Well, what is this the operating system that have the most open source user on it? You could arguably debate that's Windows. Let's take a dive into what I mean by this. I actually have a program up here if it wants to load. I mean, the virtual machine with Windows, they can be a little bit slowish. Virtual Studio Code. You could easily argue that there are way more people utilizing this open source program under Windows than under Linux. Let's go into the good old Google. Well, we are going to use Google, but we are under Chrome here. So let's do OBS Studio. This is also an open source program. If we look into here, we should see the license code here. The GPL 2 or later. What platform do you think OBS Studio have the most users on? Probably Windows. Like, you can't go on to Twitch, which is a live streaming platform, and not see OBS. Like, OBS is probably the most popular gaming recording software, live streaming software, screen recording software, broadcasting software on Windows, Linux, and Mac. Let's look at another one. Audacity. If I can actually spell it. License for this one here. GPL, and then there's like a Creative Commons license. Audacity, again, if you're talking content creation, has been almost a default go-to program for YouTuber, live streamers, or anyone that wants to do basic audio editing. And what are those? What operating system are those people using? Windows, for the most part. There are, of course, content creators using macOS and Linux. But Linux is the third wheel here. So, again, we have an open source system here that is probably most used, or open source software here that is probably most used under Windows. We can go on. I would even debate that LibreOffice is probably used more on Windows than Linux. There will be some open source projects that are probably most used under Linux. Like, if it's like the distribution itself, if it's like the package manager, if it's like, you know, a program that's made to only run under Linux, of course, and stuff like that. But if you take the popular open source program, let's see what is the most popular. So if we just look at it in here, we have top 10 open source software examples. And Mozilla Firefox, well, there are by far more Mozilla Firefox users on the Windows and macOS than Linux. LibreOffice, that one we can debate a little bit. Game, again, I we can kind of debate it, but I will still suspect that there are more GIMP users on the Windows than on the Linux, but we don't really know. VLC, oh my god, I've been using VLC on Windows ever since it came out. And VLC is probably also mostly used under Windows. And Linux itself, well, we have Windows subsystem for Linux. Blender. I will again suspect that there are more Blender users under Windows than Linux, but again, we don't really have any data, and it's hard to get those data. So again, why do I say Audacity and OBS Studio and stuff like that? Well, like I said, just go on to YouTube. Almost any content creator talks about OBS and Audacity. Go on to Twitch streamers. Almost any streamer on Twitch, or most streamers on Twitch, talk about OBS and Audacity. So it kind of speaks for itself there. But again, I would suspect that it would not be out of the field to say that Blender have most users under Windows or the same amount. The GNU compiler, that probably is Linux. Python, that's probably Windows that's winning that one there. PHP, probably also Windows winning their shortcut, probably Linux. What I'm trying to say here is that without Windows, we'll probably not have a lot of the support for the open source software that we have. So why am I saying these crazy outlandish things? Well, if you have the majority of your users under Windows like OBS have and Audacity have, that also means that most of the feedback, the contributions, the giving back to the community comes from that platform. That would be the logic conclusion to come to. The platform that your software has the most users on would also be the platform that you get most help from in any way, shape, and form that you could think of. The fact that there are so many people using open source software on Windows is actually good for us, because they help us make the software better. Because if there is a, let's say, a UI bug under Audacity or OBS, that will help us. If there is a feature request that the, you know, the user base want to see under OBS in Windows, it will also probably for the most part be, you know, implemented in the Linux version. So we will benefit from that also. So it's not like, oh, they are only implementing Windows only features. No, it's actually benefiting us also. But I sadly hear this notion that, oh, if you want to run open source software, Linux is the most popular way of doing it. Depends on the software. This is not meant to spite a debate about which is best and stuff like that, or which blasphemy that we're actually benefiting from Windows users using the software under Windows. Look at it like that. Look at it not like that, but look at it like this. We are brothers. Or you know, we are members of the same community, Windows users and Linux users. We are using the same software a lot of instances. Like I said, OBS, if you're a Windows user, Mac users, Windows user, and you want to record a gameplay as your screen, or you want to live stream, 99% of people will be using OBS. So if you're an OBS fan or you're an OBS user, you should be happy that OBS is supporting more platforms. You should be happy for your brothers and sisters using OBS on Windows or macOS, because if they have a problem with it, or like I said, a feature request or something they think it can be doing better that we Linux users have not thought about, that will benefit us. Just like if we have something we wish OBS could do, it will benefit them. So Windows and macOS and Linux helps to make open source software better. Isn't that great? Like, is that not... Like, I think that's a neat thing. That's also why I don't really like these OS wars. They're a little bit pointless, if you ask me. I hope you kind of understand what I'm saying here. So see you all later. Think a little bit about this. What is your thought about this whole thing? It's a little bit of a video to stir your thought process a little bit. See you all later. Bye-bye.